No election goes by without its surprise. Newly formed, the There is Such a People party was expected to score big, but no one predicted how big. It could very well push aside the Socialist Party and hold the most seats, second only to Prime Minister Boyko Borisov's GERB party. In typical fashion, the new party's leader, TV show host and singer Slavi Trifonov refused to do any interviews or TV appearances before revealing he had COVID symptoms and took to Facebook to thank his supporters.
Usually, all parties declare themselves winners after the elections. Today, you are the winners. You claimed back the power, and change is inevitable.
His take on politics has been unlike anything before in Bulgaria. On the day of the vote, for instance, politicians usually informed the media in advance where and at what time they would vote. After a photo op while casting their ballot, they head out and say something to rally supporters.
I want to thank all our volunteers who will be supervising the election. We are expecting a fair election.
I voted to rid the country of the mafia in government and in public finances.
Slavi Trifonov had other ideas from the very moment he started campaigning.
There were no campaign ads or billboards. No party member ever appeared in a TV debate. There is Such a People only ever used its own TV channel and social media to reach out to voters.
Instead of party meetings or TV appearances in times of COVID, Slavi Trifonov answered questions from fans in an informal setting.
Since we're in the middle of an election campaign, I'll be answering your questions. I don't need intermediaries. Journalists are just retranslators. I know this from experience since I've been working in the field for many years.
There is Such a People closed its campaign with a concert in an empty arena. The party's policy proposals remain vague and unclear, and its approach might even be viewed as populist. It is, however, looking like a new political force to be reckoned with.
Speaking after the polls closed, Prime Minister Boyko Borisov called on his opponents to join forces for the sake of the country.
This is my offer to all of you. Let us choose the best people to do the job. United, we're strong. Do you have a more experienced leader than me? Somebody more supported internationally? Somebody who successfully managed three crises? I know what I'm talking about, and I'm glad that so many parties have made it into Parliament, because I'm tired of bearing alone the whole responsibility.
Well, joining me now is Hristo Panchugov, assistant professor at political science department at the New Bulgarian University. Thanks very much for joining us on Good Morning Europe. So the Prime Minister, Boyko Borisov, in bullish mood there. What are his chances of forming a new coalition?
Well, there seems to have been one consensus in Bulgarian society for the last couple of months, and that is that Boyko Borisov could no longer be a prime minister, or that was the main theme of the campaign of everyone who is now entering the parliament. The only thing that we don't know for certain is what is the course of action of Slavi Trifonov, since he didn't really discuss politics, nor has tried to frame how that change that he's talking about is going to look like in the next parliament. There is good and bad idea about his result. The good idea, the good part of the result is that obviously the protest energy of the last year is still alive, even embodied in Slavi Trifonov. The bad idea is that now he will be probably given a mandate to form a government with people that no one has ever met in terms of their political career, and without any clear idea of what direction, political direction, the country should be headed. So if the parties that enter the parliament are true to their promises, no coalitional cabinet with Boyko Borisov or GERB, for that matter, could be possible in the next parliament.
Now, you touched on the protests last year. Thousands of people on the streets of Sofia complaining about corruption. And yet here we do have Boyko Borisov still in a commanding position, or at least in the lead after these elections. What happened to those protests and the themes there? How come Borisov has still come out on top?
Well, the protest vote has been split into a couple of players in Bulgarian politics. But most importantly, none of them could actually frame the change and the fight against the issues that the protest raised in a motivating way. This campaign has been having the sense of fear around it. The other good news is that the low turnout that everyone expected didn't really realize. So basically, we have less turnout than we're used to, but quite a bit higher than we were expecting. So basically, the people don't like the political system. However, they voted to get rid of GERB, or they voted to keep GERB into power. They voted out of fear that something that they care about will not happen. What they didn't see is motivation. What they didn't see is clear leadership with regards to political change and the ability of the political leaders to set up an agenda that is common and that is targeted against the current state of affairs, corruption, the problems with the rule of law, et cetera, et cetera. So the outcome is pretty straightforward. Yes, the protest vote is out there. However, split in this way, it simply allowed for GERB to continue its domination of Bulgarian party system. To what extent that will continue, we don't know for now.